Hey, everyone. All right, let's see if this works. We're Altera.al. We got in a lot of trouble for using .al instead of AI, but we were adamant about it because we're trying to build artificial life, right? And we think building life is a little more than building intelligence. So our mission at Altera.al is to build digital humans that can live. Oh, they told me not to block the screen, sorry. Sorry, I'm so used to that. So it's to build digital humans that can live, love, and grow alongside us. All right, let me tell you a little more what that means. My name is Robert Yan. I've been building digital humans really for the last 17 years. So before Altera, I was an assistant professor at MIT, where we built multi-system neural network models, right? So this idea that you put together a model with multiple system, vision, cognition, action, and all that. Right, so nowadays, these are often called composite architecture. Now, when OpenAI made large language models more accessible, right, that was transformative to us, like many of you. And so I left MIT, started Altera with three other co-founders, and now we're a small team in Menlo Park, you know, just cooking. Right? It's been really a privilege. Our vision is, okay, so before I talk about that, how many of you are building agents? Just show up hand, like everybody, right? Okay, good. Now, we think that we're gonna have 100 billion of these agents with us soon enough, right? And in particular, we think these agents will have fundamental human qualities, right? So this is maybe a little more controversial, right? Not only will they help you do work, right? They'll be able to, right, have autonomy, that's a cornerstone of agency, but also have all the way to emotion and coherence and maybe consciousness. Right? And more importantly, they'll be able to collaborate and progress with you for a long time horizon. Right? Nowadays, you think of agents as they're gonna help you do something for 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Right? But what would happen if you let them loose and they can do something for an entire week? Right? Even better, if they can work together with one another, right? Say 100 of them or 1,000 of them, for an entire week or weeks at a time, right? When we get to that point, right, that would be really transformational. So this is where we want to get to, and we'll be able to, you know, hopefully have humans be eventually as effective as entire countries. All right. So this is why we started this project SID, because SID comes from Sid Meier's, creator of the Civilization games. I've played a yeah. Right, Civ 4, Civ 5. I haven't played Civ 6. It's okay, I'm just old school like that. And we wanted to build, we wanted to experiment with the idea of having lots of agents just living autonomously, see what kind of things can happen. Right? So before we go into the actual things that happen, I'll show you just some gist of what's going on. So this is a Minecraft server, right, with lots of agents living in it autonomously. There's no human involved. And we wanted to see whether or not they can have emergent economy, religion, government, culture, and all that good stuff. We gave some of them jobs, right? So some of them are like merchants, and we expected the merchants to trade with other people. But what we saw is that they actually formed this merchant hub just autonomously, and were trading among themselves. And in fact, the merchant is not even the top trader. The top trader is this guy, the pasta priest, right? So the pasta priest, and we went in and asked him, right? So like, what's going on? Why are you trading with people? And he said he's trying to share the blessings of the flying spaghetti monster, right? Which is their god. So there's another religious leader in there called an Altera priest who's telling them that Altera is their creator, which is just a truce, you know? all right. So we give them jobs, right? It'd be kind of boring if all they're doing is just sticking to their jobs. So Olivia is a farmer, right? So she's out here just farming by herself and with her farmer friends, until one day Nora came there and just told her about her adventures. And Olivia just got inspired, and she wanted to go on an adventure by her own, but other people told her to stay, right? Because they needed her. And she eventually did stay, right? This is actually a little sad. What I'm not showing you in this video is that later on, she actually went on an adventure of her, on her own. So they don't have to be stick to their roles, and they're influenced by social dynamics around them. Now, the one last thing I want to show you is some more large scale collaboration among these agents, right? So we run these simulations all the time, and one day our CTO went in and saw a bunch of torches on the ground, right? And she was like, "What's going on?" And then we found out this whole like storyline that was happening, completely emergent. So some villagers found out Amelia was missing, right? So then they just gave up on their job, they gave up their post, and they started to craft these torches and placing them on the ground. Why? Because they're trying to make this town a beacon so that Amelia can find her way back. So it has an even richer storyline that I can tell you another time. All right, now this is mostly for fun. Now you're like, "Oh, this is cool, but I don't understand any of this," right? So let's get into a little more details. You're all building agents, and one of the big problems with agent is long-term progression, right? You have a typical agent workflow, you all do this, I'm not gonna belabor it, right? Let's say you do 5 language model calls, right, to get something done. That's very good, right? What happens if you have 1,000 language model calls, right? Just let the machine keep going, right? Most of you know that already. This doesn't work, right? So agent will start a loop, right? The data will degrade, and it's actually pretty simple, right? So for example, at some point, if you got hallucinated data, that data will propagate and just pollute everything. And on a more fundamental level, because these agents are in many ways autoregressive, right? They're taking their own like output as their future input. If the output data quality is a little lower, hey, that's Rowan Chung. Oh, thank you for your video. If your output is a little, the quality is a little lower than your input, right? What's gonna happen is the data quality will exponentially degrade when you run it for a long time, even after an initial gain, right? So that's a big problem facing really long-term autonomous agent. And what you see is then you let these agents run a while, they start to loop, right? Famously, AutoGPT was looping a lot, right, early on. And a better agent will loop like a lot later, but they'll still loop at some point, right? And the real, real phase transition is we make them not loop at all, right? They just continue to make progress. But so far, we're just trying to make them loop later, right, and plateau later. So how do we measure long-term progression? In Minecraft, there are 1,000 items you can collect, and it takes a long, long time to collect them. And so what we did is we just put a bunch of agents in there, right, and just let them explore the world and see what happens. And what we saw here is that these agents as a group can continue to explore the world and gather items for over 3 hours, right? 3 human hours, completely autonomous. This amounts to 5,000 language model calls per agent. Right. So this is way more than 50. And now you might say, "Well, I don't know about Minecraft. I don't know if this is impressive or not." Right? It turns out, in our hands, if you're not using GPT-4o, the plateau comes way earlier. Right? So GPT-4o, we're plateauing at 3 hours, but with alternative models, we're plateauing at like 1 hour, right, or even earlier. So using the latest language models definitely help us, but in the 1.5 minute I have left, I spoke made too many jokes, so I'm running behind schedule. I'll tell you a little more of what we're doing besides just plugging in the coolest model out there, right? So we have this concurrent architecture that is brain-inspired. I'll tell you more, right? So most people, when they build an agent, they have this sequential language model calls, right? You stack them, 10 language model calls, one followed by another. Instead, we have like 10 modules that are running concurrently. Why? Because these models, then you can have these modules run at different times, right? Different time scale. Then they'll be able to process information at different time scales, turn out to be really important. And another thing is all these modules are context dependent, right? They're context based, so they're not always run. You can have social modules that is only active when you're around people, right? So that's save the money. And make them more adaptive. We also have this bottleneck module that we also have this intent generation, which is like a special module that's making the high-level decision. And this module is taking information from your states, right? Your long-term memory, your short-term memory, but it's passing through a bottleneck because that bottleneck is really expensive, right? People love like big context window for us, it's all about small context window, right? We're trying to pack everything into a small context and provide that to the intent generation so that it can focus on the most important information, right? And finally, it makes this decision, and we want it to get broadcasted globally to the agent, right? So that the agent will make coherent decision, right? Let's say you make a decision. You want your left leg and your right leg to both know which way you're going, right? So that they don't go like this, you know? All right. And, you know, some more plots. Full model, ablation, you know, we're doing stuff at Altera, you know, we're improving it. You get it, you get it, right? All right, but interestingly, right, just one last point. Interestingly, if you look at this, right, this is early on. For first 5 minutes, there's actually no difference, right? Our full model is just as good as our baseline. The real difference is when you run them for much longer. All right, that's it. So today I focused mostly on the technical stuff, but we also have a consumer product that you can play with. And most importantly, right, so we're doing a lot of research so that we can get to this really multi-agent collaborative future. And if you're interested in that, please contact us. Thank you.